Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Epic 7 on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Epic 7 and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Epic 7. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, to get started we need to open our main browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to that URL that I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type this URL, simply because there's a link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed right here on our site of Usitility, exactly where we include a detailed information on the best way to obtain Epic 7 on laptop or computer. We scroll down a bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is only the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to that game Epic 7 on the PC. As you can discover from here, we access some advantages of preferring using the emulator. Now we will proceed to download the Epic 7 by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. The step is clicking on the button. And the download action starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to launch the executable file. Okay, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I minimized the browser to view the installation software significantly better. The installer is pretty simple. It includes a couple of choices, install and setup path. I will explain what setup path truly does. We simply just click it. And we observe that we get here the path where the emulator is going to be placed. If we wish to vary this folder we have to click on that Browse option, and now we choose another folder and install the emulator where we choose. I prefer to set it where it is. Then, I click on Back. And I simply click on Install. Now, there it is. The installation starts and it is going to carry on along with the download of these MB that happens to be represented on our computer screen. After you download it, it is likely to be a little bit more or less megabytes. The download rate can be at a higher speed or at a lower speed, depending on your internet and depending on the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Today they are going really fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you can see, down here, there is a progress bar which will advance to the right then when it reaches the finish, the emulator is started for the first time. In fact, the emulator has already been launched, there for the first time. Before we continue, as you can discover, it made a couple of software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is going to be the one we're concerned about. When we want to start Epic 7 on our PC, we twice mouse-click on that app icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's do the next step, which is actually a requirement, and which is to access the Google Play Store. And we will click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is launched. There we are required to sign in. Now when we are on this page, we have to conduct the following step that is definitely compulsory. Therefore mouse click on, Sign In. Now it says, Checking Info. It may once in a while get blocked in checking info, additionally it does not advance. If so, you can try to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it will surely probably be solved. Now we will type in our email address and password. The email address must be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. As an example you make use of the exact same email you're using right now in your YouTube account. So that I will submit my details and I will come back as soon as I have accomplished it. That's it, data inserted. Discover Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We should say yes to all of them by just clicking, I agree. Next, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it selected and it will build a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you can make use of this feature if you prefer. We click on accept. Google Play is launched by default and completely on its own. To set up the video game, we need to browse the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking the app icon designated in green. Now that we are on the desktop of the emulator for Android, we observe that we have now here the install application option. We simply click on this button. Here we get the video game. Let's simply click right here on the install button that I am just presenting now in green color. And it will begin the setup. Straight away it should download and install the game app. It can take a little while or perhaps it may possibly be extremely fast. It all is dependent upon on our internet connection. This has by then ended setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting that option that I'm showing in green, in order to start Epic 7 for the very first time. We are by now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're about to simply click this brand new Epic 7 software icon which has been provided. The game is launched for the first time on your computer. Now there we end up with it, I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume of that emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of the emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the max, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is the first one, we mouse click on this particular app icon that I am indeed designating in green color. And the screen is maximized, getting one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. If we desire to experience the application in full screen, we hit this game icon. And we might by now be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen mode. To quit the complete screen setting, just click the F11 key. And we might by now play in regular display mode. Now I am starting to present you the computer keys mapping that is definitely very enjoyable. That strategy we definitely will be ready to utilize the game far more easily. The first task is to press this software icon. And there you will be able to make the recommended configuration settings. I can leave the standard settings, however if you plan to improve that, you can do so without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is launched in the improper language, such as, in Japanese. And to set it in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. And here within many other options, we click the language drop down. We can select the language we need, Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. When the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, and also the game application, next time we use it, would also be in the selected language. Now, there is another aspect that we have to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email telling you that a brand new electronic device has been connected with our own Google account. It will check with us if we are the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Yup, we may not worry, because the emulator is emulating in Google Android device. And to discover which electronic device is currently being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And we go here to the model option. And now we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for this video user demo. I anticipate you appreciated it, especially that everyone thought it was handy. If that is so, bring it a great like, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer your comments, issues or ideas, put them in the comment area below. You can also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams from time to time, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of those videos that are appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming training videos. Bye.